Welcome to Center Stage again for another great season. Now I can actually say we are in the second season of Center Stage. So much to talk about, so much to bring your way, but we have to start the second season the way we started the first, with our amazing superintendent, Mr. Warren Drake. Stay tuned.
You see, that's been your problem from the beginning. Everywhere you go, you make enemies. And I think, well, this guy's intelligent, articulate. Why the heck can't he take a break? Why doesn't he get that if history has taught us anything, it's that every great man has a team of people who support him. A team of people who respect this great man so much that when they wake up in the morning, they think, what does black people bring us?
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Center Stage. Today we have Mr. Warren Drake, the superintendent of East Baton Rouge Parish Schools. How are you today, Mr. Drake?
I'm doing great. It's a great day in EBR.
It always is a great day in EBR. We do wonderful things in EBR, but I'm mostly proud of the visual and performing arts that we have here in this district. Mr. Drake has done wonderful things, and I have to thank you for the things that you've given us in the parish in the name of performing art. So much has changed from last year to this year, and we've made amazing strides from last year to this one. So do you want to talk a little bit about what we've done?
Well, I think the arts are fantastic, and you know, we've had several budget reduction years, but this has been a very big year. But the arts are so critical and so key in our district that it's really important to maintain the integrity of our arts program. So I'm very proud of that. You know, we have so many individual things I can talk about, but just the fact that arts is viable, strong, and continues to grow in EBR, I think is amazing and really important.
Very important. And this year, we also see a continuation of some great things that you've allowed us to do from last year. This was the first year we actually had over 250 teachers play a part in professional development. Thanks to you, Mr. Drake gave us that opportunity for those professional development days for those teachers to specifically have that. How important is professional development for teachers?
Well, it's just like our students. We have to train ourselves. You know, you're always learning. The status quo is not acceptable. You know, you have to be better tomorrow than you are today. And so that professional development helps us do that. You know, and I want to go back and say, Sean, that I consider EBR a AAA district. You know, academics, arts, athletics. When you talk about things like that, there's something for everyone in our district.
It is. And now for teachers, when you have teachers that come to me and say, can you tell Mr. Drake just in case we don't see him, thank you for the professional development or the opportunities that we see for kids. Because if you notice around the city of Baton Rouge, you have students performing just about everywhere in this city, doing wonderful things, winning awards that I would say I hadn't seen before. But under his administration and moving forward with the emphasis on the arts, you're beginning to see certain different things.
You know, what you focus on gets better.
Right.
And what you put your attention in and to gets better.
Right.
And I think that in a district like ours, you know, a viable arts program is really key because the kids, it makes them want to come to school, number one.
Right.
You know, not everybody learns the same. Not every student can do the same thing. But there are certain students that the arts, they just love, and they will not miss a day of school. It may be learning how to play the guitar or piano or singing or visual arts. Whatever it is, having that opportunity for our children is really critical for us.
And do you want to tell our listening audience about our new venture with the Arts Integration Program at Park Elementary?
Well, I'll tell you, Park Elementary almost didn't happen. And I want to thank the people of Baton Rouge because in the last phase three of the tax plan, the people of Baton Rouge approved building a new Park Elementary School. It is the first 21st century elementary school in the city and maybe even the state. But along with partnering with Westdale Heights, that school is integrating the arts into the classrooms. And look, when you see students who have the arts integration, you see higher scores. And you know, I will say that our academics has grown every year except the year of the flood in the last 5 years. And I think we're going to be able to show again this year significant growth. We've already looked at some indices where we're seeing growth. mm-hmm. and even doubling the state's average in growth. Mm-hmm. But I think part of that success is due to the students wanting to be at school, and when they do the arts and when they put their hands on it, it becomes a part of that culture of the school, and it's right. been very successful.
Right. But thank you to you. We've never had a school that was truly, that wasn't a magnet school or a dedicated school to some specialty program to have an opportunity like this.
Well, when you look at Park Elementary School, when you go through a piece of that school and there's an art mm-hmm. room with two kilns, mm-hmm. you have a dance studio. Now, mm-hmm. this is a school built for a maximum of 450 students. Mm-hmm. A dance studio, an art studio, mm-hmm. a physical education workout room
right.
that even the community can use.
Right.
And then, of course, all the other things that go along with that, connected to the auditorium, mm-hmm. for a school like that, that mm-hmm. is just a win-win. I mean, any school in Baton Rouge, would, if they would see that, they'd be so
course.
Envious.
And
of
it's a beautiful, exactly, and it's
really.
A beautiful campus.
Absolutely.
Beautiful campus, and it's so many wonderful things going on there. So before we leave, we know this is Mr. Drake's last year as superintendent. The 1920 school year will be an epic one for our superintendent. So knowing that it's I know it's probably bittersweet, but leaving out, what would you want our listening audience to know? What would you like for us to remember as your legacy to EBR schools?
Well, definitely the arts is one of them. Mm-hmm. You know, I tried to learn how to play the guitar. Didn't mm-hmm. work too well. I played the baritone.
Uh-huh.
Didn't work so well, but
uh-huh.
I had to march in the band, too.
Uh-huh.
Where I came from, you marched in the band and you played football.
Right, right.
But I think, overall, it's building a strong foundation. We mm-hmm. have grown academically, not just in the academic pieces, but in the arts. Mm-hmm. Athletically, our fields are better. Mm-hmm. We're getting more participation there. Our growth, student growth, is up. And I think that's an indicator of the community of Baton Rouge saying there's good things going on in EBR schools.
Right.
And I will tell you, over the last 6 months, our public relations department has gotten the word out to the community
mm-hmm.
that you need to take a look at EBR schools. The Explore EBR Schools magazine we put out, I still see it all
oh, yes.
over Baton Rouge.
Great
and
magazine,
I,
too.
And I think when the families of Baton Rouge take a look at us, they're seeing things that they can find something for their child in our system.
Oh, most definitely.
You know, but I think my legacy is going to be building a very strong foundation in all three of those areas.
Mm-hmm.
But the arts is very critical to that. It's
mm-hmm.
it's one of the areas that I don't know much about,
mm-hmm.
but I know how important
mm-hmm.
it is.
Mm-hmm. He knows a lot. He's being modest here. He knows a lot about the arts. And we always like to end with something just fun. So last season, we asked Mr. Drake about his favorite musical artist. So this time, we're going to ask him about his favorite actor or actress. So who is that?
Well, it has to be Clint Eastwood.
Okay.
I mean, I love the movies Clint Eastwood has done all the way back to the 60s
mm-hmm.
when Hollywood would not take his movies
mm-hmm.
and he went to Italy.
Mm-hmm.
And there was an Italian producer that did those three, that trilogy
mm-hmm.
of like A Few Dollars More,
mm-hmm.
The Good, Bad, and the Ugly.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And I can't remember the other one right now.
Mm-hmm.
But even back to that point and then on Rawhide
uh-huh. oh,
on
of
television.
Course. Of course.
And of course the most recent movie he made, which was Mule.
Uh-huh.
All of those movies
uh-huh.
have just, I love Clint Eastwood.
Right.
I think his movies are just fantastic.
Oh, he's a legend. He's a legend. And now leaving us as a legend as superintendent of East Baton Rouge Parish Schools. Mr. Drake, I can speak for myself and I know I can speak for many others. I'm definitely going to miss you, and I have learned a lot from you. What I've learned more so from Mr. Drake is thinking out of the box and putting children first. The priority is always children, and whatever you bring to the system, bring it 110%. And I want to thank you for allowing me to do that through the arts.
Well, you're very welcome. You're very gracious. And we are on the move, not just academically, but in the arts.
Yes.
And I would say that anybody out there watching this just needs to take a look at us. The arts we have here are second to none, and
right.
I just appreciate everything you've done here. And
Thank you.
I've enjoyed every job I've ever had,
uh-huh. Uh-huh.
You know, from teacher all the way to where I am right now. But I know that I could not have done it without the staff that I have. I've had fantastic staff here, you and all of the group that works in the schools and in our central office have done a great job, and I want to thank them for their support over the years. Yes. I couldn't do it without them. You can't do this job by yourself.
No.
And so I want to say thank you to the people of Baton Rouge for supporting EBR schools over the years. My kids went through this school system mm-hmm. and are very successful. Mm-hmm. Most of the people I know, their kids went through this school system. Both of our U.S. senators graduated from EBR
right.
schools.
Right.
And I just want to say we are a system on the rise and on the move. And take a look at us if you're not here right now. But thank you, Mr. Joe, for
thank you, Mr. Drake,
for everything you've done.
Thank
for
you,
us as
thank
well.
You. So now we are not going to leave you. We want to show you some highlights from last season to let you know what may be coming your way this season on Center Stage. Until next time, we will see you in your front row seat on Center Stage.
Nobody knows.